And welcome back. 17 levels to get power 4 if we can pull it off. But it's just me and BTC at this point. I cannot make health potions. I can make speed potions, though. And strength. Yeah, that's what we're going to do. So, this has been interesting, hasn't it? Quite the season. Man. Quite the season. Don't need that. Might be that time. You had a book? Efficiency one, huh? Is BTC still playing? He hasn't said anything in a very long time. Oh, I didn't, I don't have redstone, darn. Want those bottles back. Hey man.
Are you offering your unconditional surrender?
I am not offering my unconditional surrender.
I figured it was worth asking.
Are you?
No. Not doing too bad.
Too bad. I'm a little low now. But I think we should end this.
I'm a little bad, so it doesn't really matter.
It bounces out.
Yeah, exactly. I'm a little bit bad, so. Let me see.
So we don't need to set coordinates, like exact coordinates, but if you want to stay within an area.
Okay.
For a little bit and see how that goes. How big do you think? You want to stay within 200? That's like plus and minus 200.
Yeah.
400 by 400. Okay. Oh, I messed something up. Oh, I just had like the longest battle with Pidolo.
Oh, really?
Yeah. It was crazy.
I'm just finishing this dealio, and then I'll
just... So have you been having a good time?
It's different. I gotta keep reminding myself that it's UHC because I tend to play recklessly.
Mm-hmm.
In vanilla, and I'll jump off of cliffs and all sorts of stuff like that. I mean that's actually how I took my first little bit of damage was I just wasn't paying attention. Yep, just being careless, basically.
Oh man, so long. You get so stressed out towards the end of these things, just from talking for so long.
Oh yeah, I mean it's really easy to do it. Well, it's easier when you have someone that you're with.
Mm-hmm.
But when you're by yourself, it does press on the nerves a bit. How many people? You killed two, correct? Two or three?
I think three or four now, I think.
Really? Oh, wow.
Yeah, four.
You're off killing people. I'm just here macerating.
You gotta do it. It's part of the game, too.
All right. So basically anything within the 200.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
I'll start plus moving into now. Did you see Zista's crazy tower?
No, I kept seeing people complaining about it.
I think what happened is he pillared up in the sky, put lava around it.
And then he trapped himself?
Yeah, and he kind of hung up around up there for a bit. I think somebody else tried to pillar up to get him, too.
Mm-hmm.
And I don't know what happened with that. But there's like two pillars side by side.
Probably was Anders, because I think he was.
And I'm guessing Zisto derped and just accidentally fell in his lava at the end.
Oh, yeah. I thought that was kind of fitting. Oh.
Mm-hmm. All right, I'm within boundaries.
I'm still making my way there.
It's raining. Did you have trouble at the start with like mobs in caves?
I actually, when I first went down, I was in a mine shaft, and that was just bad ideas all over the place.
I have never seen as many mobs as I did this time.
Oh jeez.
It was, yeah, it was crazy.
Completely surrounded by cave spiders everywhere. It was just, yeah, it was anti-pretty. For sure.
Anti-pretty.
Anti-pretty. Most definitely.
Good had a ton of dogs.
Oh, did he?
Yeah. Like as many as he could make.
I had a bunch, but I don't know. They just derped and they didn't want to teleport, so I have none.
I was crafting something here, and I totally forgot what now. Huh. It was important. I can't remember now.
Oh, I'm sure you don't need it.
Oh, probably not.
Especially if it was some sort of weapon or armor. You can just take that off.
Oh, I remember now. Thank you. Needed a wooden sword. No. Alright. Yeah, caving this time, it's the most trouble I've ever had.
Well, I'm terrible at the whole caving part anyways, so it was just, yeah. It was just anti-pretty. It was not good. It was not good.
I thought for a while I might actually die from skeletons or something. I got down to like 3.5. Just kind of being a little reckless. Not thinking I would take much damage, but oh man.
I actually didn't take any skeleton damage. I'm surprised because I fought quite a few of them, and I just got lucky, really. Oh, this is so agonizing. There's so much water.
You kind of tipped me off where you were.
Yeah. That's fine.
Oh, I went out of the boundary. Go back, go back.
I'm not even in the boundary yet, so... I'm slowly working my way there.
Is this your first one where you weren't on teams?
Yeah.
How'd you find it?
Yep. It's good, but like I said, it's just I tend to be more reckless, and I had to consciously remind myself several times, like, stop doing that. You're gonna take damage. Like the first time, like the first half heart damage I took was fall damage, just because I was being careless.
Mm-hmm.
And that was I think in the first episode, so. All right, I am just about in boundary.
You're not where I thought you would be. Not that I really want to kill you when you're in the water. That would be kind of cheap, but...
All right, I'm in boundary.
Okay. It's 400 by 400.
Oh, really? Oh.
Well, it's 200.
Yeah.
But that's the size.
I was like, wait a minute.
Oh no. Dang it, I couldn't even hit you.
Strength potion and speed potion.
Did you get one?
Yep.
That's what I was trying to put on. Oh, that sucks.
There are my carrots. By the way, spoiler alert, I didn't find a single gold ore in the entire game.
Wow.
The only gold I got was when I went, I'm like, I can't do this. I'm like, I'm just going to go gas hunting. And that's what I did. So I went gas hunting for a few minutes and I killed like three or four of them and I only got one. I'm like, this isn't worth it.
Wow. So, where did you get the potions from? Did you go to the Nether then?
Yep. I went to the Nether. Someone else had already robbed all of the Nether wart. So I had to go back through and
It was never
keep searching. Oh, it was?
Yeah.
So
pretty sure. Dang, I can't believe I didn't see you that.
Yeah, you didn't even see me. I was coming right up on you.
Darn it.
And with the speed potion, so good game.
Good game. What did I get you to? I didn't even hit you, did I?
I'm only down 4 hearts.
Wow.
And I didn't heal once all game. So yep, I couldn't find any gold. None at all.
Wow.
So
well, good game. Well, there you have it, everyone. That is the end of UHC Season 11. I hope you guys enjoyed it. That was a crazy season, wasn't it? Oh, man. I think it's been my favorite one so far. So many memorable events happened this season. I did really like Season 4, A and B as well. That was pretty cool. But this one, I think it tops that even. So... I decided I would do a little wrap-up speech of the season here and of the episode and the battle there. Let's talk about the end fight there, first of all. So, judging from the comments I've seen, I'm guessing a lot of you were not suspecting that ending. I was not myself. That was very surprising. From the time I saw him to the time I died, that whole fight lasted a total of like 6 seconds, so... Very quick battle there.
I did not have much time to think, and I did not know what he had. I was really shocked to hear he had potions afterwards, because looking at his health throughout the season, you know, he was low. I figured he had just low-level enchants, and that was about it. But nope. He had an ace in his sleeve. So, that end fight there, that situation, I knew I had to react very quickly there. I whispered, or like typed in the chat to you guys my plan. My plan was to drink my Strength 2 and Speed 2 potions, and I was sort of hanging around the plains biome there so I could see him from a distance. And, you know, take my time to drink my potions and engage him the way I wanted. But it just so happens I walked by the one tiny hill in the plains biome that BTC happened to be behind, and I happened to get just a little too close to it, and you know the rest. So in that fight, my reaction at the start there, I'll explain that. I knew in that moment, if I did nothing, if I didn't drink my potion and I just engaged in a straight sword battle, there was a very good chance I was going to lose because he had the health advantage there. And I usually don't fare too well in sword battles. Usually someone will get the first two hits on me and then it kind of evens out. Usually that's the way it works for me. I decided, based on my plan, like my instinct or my reaction was programmed in already, that I was going to drink the potion. So that's what I turned to. I wasn't able to really think it through. And I thought I had time to drink it, but yeah, he had a speed potion, so he approached me pretty quick. Even still, I'm not sure if I would have been able to drink it quick enough, looking back. Even if he got one hit on me, though, I think it would have... I don't know. It's a hard call. But, yeah, he hit me. I got locked into a knockback storm there. And it wasn't until I got pressed up against some land or something that I was actually able to hit him, even though I had my cursor on him. That's just the way sword battle works sometimes in this game. So, oh well. The proper thing for me to have done there was to just switch to my bow and try to knock him back, get some distance, then drink my potions. But if I had missed one arrow or two, I think I would have died regardless. I wouldn't have been able to hold him back for very long. So it was a tough situation to be in. Yeah. Anyway, it was a good battle. Congrats to BTC for surviving to the end there and for winning. And also, let's talk about the season a little bit. So the Eternal Day thing, I really liked it, actually. I wasn't sure at the start of the season if it was going to be any good. I kind of had my doubts, but, you know, it made caving all the more crazy and fun. It made going around looking for people a lot easier, and I think it helped to encourage battles. I liked it. I think it was good. I don't think we should do it all the time, but once in a while, I think it's a good change. There's sort of some strategy that gets lost when you take out the normal day-night cycle with it, but, you know, there's pros and cons to both. But I hope we do it again in future seasons. The season itself, man, there was a lot of really cool and memorable events. It was cool to have Dinnerbone join us this season. Also, Shree played for the first time, which was nice. There was... I was able to get into a lot of the action, which is something I aim for every season. I got into 5 battles total. There was a lot of really crazy battles this season, like that one with Curtin and B00, that was pretty cool. B00 getting super lucky this season, that was pretty funny. And just the way that whole potion thing worked out, it was unbelievable. And then at the end of the season, it was really neat how everybody sort of had something different that gave them an advantage. So it wasn't a clear cut someone was going to win at the end there. Everybody sort of had something that could have allowed them to win, like out of the final six or seven people. So that made things pretty interesting, and yeah, not too many PvE deaths this season either, which is nice. It was mostly everybody got a chance to get involved in the action. As for how I played this season, I'm pretty happy with the outcome. I said before, my goal isn't exactly to win the season. It's this weird balance I have to find. It tears at me every season. My three goals when I play UHC, first and foremost, to entertain the viewers, and then also I want to have fun is my other goal. And then finally, you know, it would be nice if I could win too. That's like the cherry on top of the cake if that can happen. But I don't feel you can do all three. I don't. You have to find a balance, because ideally to win the season, your goal should be to avoid all conflict at all costs and use all your time and resources to making yourself stronger until you actually have to fight. So looking for action and for kills is not a smart plan if you're aiming to win, but I think it does add to the entertainment, and I think it definitely adds to my enjoyment. So that's why I do it that way, and I'm pretty happy. You know, I was able to get into so much action this season. But yeah, I'm looking forward to next seasons. I hope you guys are too. And I guess I'll stop rambling here and call it an end. So I did record some of the after talk, which I might include this episode, or I might put in another one. I'm not sure. But that's it for me, guys. Thanks for watching. I hope you enjoyed it, like I said. And I'll see you next time.
You Come made on, a damn bye. Fool of yourself. I was you gonna, sure I, did. Whenever you died in fire, I said, "Oh, I please let him have just killed himself." And then you said, "I'm not going to show this." And I was like, "Yes, God."
Did you just walk into lava?
What is with the lava tower?
So this is what happened. I dug down to my first mine shaft, huge cave, tons of skeletons, took some damage, left. Second mine shaft, no cave because of no strip mining rule or whatever.
Mm-hmm.
Third mine shaft, no cave. Fourth mine shaft, another huge ravine with caves coming from 10 different directions. So I never got diamonds. I never got gold, really. And I felt severely undergeared. So I was like, all right, I'm just going to go to the center of the forest or at 0-0 and wait for people to show up.
And you built an entire
fortress. Lava tower.
I tried to kill him, but he shot me off. And
I saw your second
water,
pillar there.
And just barely survived.
What we're doing on the server now? Or are we doing anything?
We're doing a post-wrap. Up.
It's over.
Recording.
Oh.
After. At the moment.
first tunnel down went into a cave shaft, and mine shaft rather, and it was just cave spiders everywhere. Absolutely everywhere. Like, I tried every which way to go. I could not find... I never got a single gold ore block in the entire...
Wow.
And you won.
Yeah? Nuts? How did the final fight go? I'm curious.
He surprised me.
Yeah.
And he had potions, too. I had potions, but I didn't get to use them.
Where did everyone get potions from? Did everybody go to the nether?
Yeah, I went to the nether.
Oh, good work, ABC. For once, Ethel didn't win. Yes.
I had a potion of swiftness on me, so I came up on him really fast before he even really knew I was there. And then a potion of strength, iron sword, sharp one, fire aspect two. It was just, yeah.
I'm looking forward to seeing B-Dubs' video where he fans our stuff.
Dude, yeah. I'm walking around and I'm like half a heart the whole time. And I was like, I'm done. You know, I'm toast unless some miracle. And I turn around and you two are fighting each other and you both die. And it's covered in gold. Good things. And I was like, this is the best Christmas ever.
No way.
I saw you were at 10 hearts and I was like, why didn't he have a heart a second ago? What happened?
I drank six potions.
Oh, wow.
Did you get from 0.5 to 10?
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
Damn.
How much does each potion heal for?
Thanks for saving one for me, B00.
I drank them all.
Doesn't matter how much. I just chugged them.
I just wanted to get one hit on Etho because I had all those dogs and I couldn't. I hate you and your rapid fire.
It wasn't even rapid fire, man.
Dogs, dude.
I got my pants. I thought it was Etho. I didn't even get time to read the name tag because I got scared.
I saw you standing there in the plains in the wide open, and you weren't even trying to shoot me. You were just standing. I think you were in a state of shock.
Yeah,
you were standing there.
Dude, I was running after you. I was thinking, yes, a good fair fight.
Episode 10.
And then I got close enough and see all of the dogs are popping up the screen and they're feeling the screen. And I'm like,
it was like a scene out of Looney Tunes.
I couldn't believe my eyes first. I my brain just froze for a second. I was, all right.
I like the idea that someone had like a wolf. I'm like, so it was like we had a wolf that was really confident and then went after you and then suddenly like 20 wolves, like,
Yeah, I have a lot more wolves.
Two fully grown and two babies. And I was like, I thought I had the upper hand, basically, but it would be at least a fair fight. But
I had two wolves and I thought I was good.
I didn't even feed that many. Like, when I left the house, I had a stack and a half of bones, and I grabbed all those dogs just walking through the forest.
My dogs triggered the pressure plate in a desert temple.
Is that why it blew up?
Ran for my life, yeah.
I found that one.
But I managed to loot three of the chests and actually got like 8 gold out of them, so that was pretty good, but I lost the 2 dogs I had from the beginning. So those dogs you saw was the ones I got later.
I'm still concerned I cannot log into Minecraft tomorrow when Dinobone wakes up.
I just feel bad we invite him and then you kill him. Yeah. So we're like, give the guy a chance.
Didn't have armor, did you?
You know, Anders broke the streak. And then I walk up there, and I was like, oh, dang, there's somebody. And I peeked down. It's Dinobone. And then,
killing pigs, and all of a sudden, like 10 blocks to my left, I see Avidia's name pop up. I just panic and then follow him and just kill him. And I basically kill him 20 blocks from my spawn point, right next to a ravine full of iron. And I'm like super happy for the first 10 seconds. And then I'm like, oh, what did I just do? But the server doesn't restart. No one says anything, really. So I'm like, okay, maybe I just like made that up in my mind. I don't know. So I just keep on trucking, like being kind of happy. I'm sorry, man.
Are we going on to do the wrap up now, or?
I think we're in the you're in the middle of it.
Yeah, that's what this is, buddy.
Welcome.
Oh, is this it? Are we recording?
No.
Hi, people.
What do we think about the always on daylight?
I
liked it.
Actually,
I liked it personally. I don't know if we should do it every season or anything like that, but I liked it.
Yeah. Did you guys find that the caves were just full of monsters?
Mm-hmm. Yep.
Oh yeah.
Well, yeah. There was definitely more mobs in the caves than normal, but it wasn't.
My only issue is that how do you get string other than finding it in a
I
found a spider spawner just walking on the surface.
I killed
spider spawners. And
I killed some spiders on the surface as well.
Yeah.
I found one that was just pouring them out on my head.
Did anyone get any crazy enchants from any spawners this season? All I got was the flame.
No. What did you have on your bow?
Resistance. I got
Bane of Afropods on a diamond sword. That was fun.
Oh, yeah.
Fire aspect 2.
I guess Anders had it.
I had Bane of Ultra Pods on one of my diamond swords. I got diamonds like the first minute of the second episode.
Oh, it took me ages to find them. But I found,
I found just enough to just not be able to make a crafting table. Mm. I was one diamond away, and it took me the next 8 episodes to find a jungle temple that had 3 diamonds in it so I could enchant my stuff.
Yeah, I never had an enchanting table. I was trying to enchant my stuff with your enchanting table, and B00's on one side of the hill, and Etho's on the other side of the hill. So I was like sandwiched between the two and trying to use your enchanting table to enchant my stuff. I ended up just putting your armor on.
Dude, your dogs were like goblins pouring into the hole I was trying to fight inside. I'm going to kill as many as possible before I die, at least. I'm gonna make sure he doesn't win. And I was sure it was Etho, too, because, like, I was... I was so scared, like, when I saw Tito. I just saw a short name. I was like, that's Tito, that guy.
I turned off my cape because I think it's too like, oh, prevalent.
Yeah. It does stand
flamboyant.
Out.
Yeah.
Too flamboyant.
Fabulous.
Yeah.
What did you get on your bow?
That was flame. I found that in the skeleton spawner that I've
just flame one or
nice. Yeah, just flame one.
Yeah.
Did you breed the dogs or did you just get tons?
Breed some of them, but most of them were from the bones from the skeleton spawner. Like I actually left my house because everyone was talking about going to the center, and that was like 2 hours in. And I left my house and I realized I saw dogs, and I was like, oh wait, I left my bones back. So I actually went back and got the bones.
What did you think of the solo PvP overall? Like, do you guys like it?
I had a lot of fun.
Yeah, I think it's good.
It makes it so much scarier.
Yeah.
It's
Oh yeah, you check your back a lot more.
It makes the commentary harder, but I think I prefer it.
I think I just sung for most of it. So.
I think there's more room for individual playstyles to come out when it's just every man.
My experience was short but intense. I didn't even get a chance to open my wine bottle, but I did now.
Oh,
God. That's the first thing I thought when he died. I was like, he didn't even have time to drink his wine.
No, not at all.
This is the first season I've ever played sober, and I think that's part of the problem.
I think I should be sober more often. That's like the best I've ever done.
I feel the same way, Milby.
I was just like, oh my God. I was seriously, when I killed Packrat, which was a really fun fight, by the way.
You didn't stab me, by the way.
I screamed. Oh, okay. Like, I was like, I was topping the microphone constantly because I was like, I just want to fight.
My first PvP kill.
Who made that blaze farm, by the way?
Probably me.
Oh, that was you. Oh, that's right. That's right. Well, thank you. Thank you. You basically enabled me to win. Appreciate it.
Are you?
High five.
You suck, Nebris.
So this is the first season where people actually got potions, right?
Yep.
Yes.
And a lot of people got potions.
You know, I think they heal more than... What do they heal? Like four
hearts?
Yeah,
they do, but...
Yeah, they do four.
I mean,
two people got potions.
I think almost every time...
Melon, too. That's the hard part.
Almost every time
I got my melon
made...
from a villager.
Well, I didn't heal once during the entire match. I lost, I think, four hearts, but I didn't heal once through the whole game. I was trying to actually get potions for invisibility, but... I couldn't find any carrots. I didn't find a carrot until I killed Etho, and then he dropped all the carrots.
So Etho, you want to know a fun fact?
What?
You dealt 26 hearts of damage to me.
You just wouldn't die, man. You wouldn't die. You would.
I drank four instant health potions, and I was full health when I met you. So,
man.
Yeah.
And you didn't save me one. I just needed one to get back up.
Not one.
Was it a close fight between you guys, or?
I felt like it was at times, but then I would check and like, he wasn't doing damage. I had a power 3 bow, so
you did a lot of damage with me with one shot, I think. But I had an instant health too. You must have left one in the chest.
Did you build all of this?
I didn't hit you once.
People are going to rage.
Mine is the iron box.
Wait, you built it this high?
Yeah.
Oh my God. I thought it was like it's a little like lava tower. I didn't think it was like a giant.
I gotta stay out of arrow range.
I saw it and I just turned around and walked off. I was like, I'm not messing with that. Screw that.
I thought when I heard like lava tower, I just thought, oh, cool. Of course this dude's built a giant lava tower. I think originally I was like, if I built like a house, just like a house, and have like home sweet home on the front.
Well, see, like my original idea is I'm gonna do this season. This is what I want to do. I'm gonna do this season and just stay out in the open, put torches everywhere, build houses. But it doesn't really have the same impact because it's always daytime. There's never that. I'm out at night and I can see the torch from a million miles away.
Right.
So I didn't do it quite the same.
I was excited. I finally made it to your lava tower, and then you like died instantly.
I had already left. I wasn't there anymore.
Oh.
But even if you wouldn't have had the daylight thing, I would have ran into Dinnerbone anyways. I was just walking about 300-400 blocks and I attacked him, so that didn't play a role. I don't know how all the other PvP
I just walked in, I saw him, and I feel super bad.
I can just feel the hit now, honestly. I think Doc's gonna get the worst of it.
Just did what I had to do. I saw a guy and I slapped him with my
You should have hugged him. You should have thanked him for making the game and just gave him all your weapons and bowed down.
No more Minecraft, guys. Minecraft is
Minecraft is over.
Minecraft has been canceled. Great.
It's been a good run, guys.
Thanks, Doc.
I'm sorry.
Thanks, Doc.
This is the first time where I was like, you know what? I got a game plan. I'm going to, it's eternal daytime. Yeah, I'm going to do all the stuff on top, and then I'm going to go down and get my stuff. And then I saw people start dying left and right, and I'm like, I better get my butt underground. Yeah. It's a bloodbath up here.
Yep. I was a dead man walking anyways. I was down to 1.5 hearts. So, I need to fight gold.
You could have had a miracle like B-dubs.
Yeah, some people came back. Have miracles.
Nebris, I can't wait to see that episode. Yeah.
This is the second time Nebris has killed someone simultaneously.
Yeah, my dog killed him in hindsight, but it was a flaming dog, too. If you held on for like one more second, that dog would have been dead.
That thunder was so obnoxious.
Oh, yeah. Wow, that was the worst I've ever heard it. Like, the game was mad at Doc.
Yeah.
How dare you kill our creator?
That came at a perfect time for me, because I was, like, following generic.
Oh, yeah, dude. How long were you scouting me out?
I was... it took me a while to get to you. I think maybe 10 minutes.
Boy, I was just like... Well, it was funny as maybe 15 minutes prior, I said, well, the one good thing about me being down here is I don't have to worry about anybody coming after me. I thought like, I just got finished. You probably was watching me. I killed like
hearing creepers, creeper explosions all over the place.
Oh, yeah.
I was like, I better get there before this guy dies.
I was so happy I spawned in like a corner. I was so happy when I spawned it.
Felt protected by the wall.
Yeah. I just was like, oh, this is best. I can happily. I felt like I was in a single player world. I was just wandering around collecting stuff. I went underground, just mined.
La di da di da.
I love that Dinnerbone. Your first YouTube video in over a year is going to be 10 minutes, and it's going to be an instant death.
Oh, stop it, B-dubs.
We should record a fake Ultra Hardcore where Dinnerbone kills everyone in 10 minutes.
Why, in God's name, I was like, the only thing that was on my mind is, don't run into Dinnerbone when you know? Like, oh, there's somebody. Look down. And I even, I go around the corner and look down to make sure, yes, it is Dinnerbone. For God's sake.
I saw you running.
Like stone swords, then?
Mm-hmm. I saw you running above me. I was exploring around trying to find a decent cave to go into, and then I just saw you walking above me. I was like, "Oh, yeah. I know you've seen me, but are you just gonna pretend like you can't fight me at this right moment?" So I tried to hide, like really futile attempts, and then you jumped down. I'm like, "Well, okay, this is it."
Yeah. But you got me good with your hoe, man.
The hoe? It was a pickaxe.
Oh, yeah. It was a pickaxe. Yeah, indeed. But it did hurt, man. There's not much difference between a stone sword and a stone hoe. Axe.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, well.
Wait, you weren't even fighting with swords then?
I didn't see draw a sword. I think it was all... I jumped down the hole and I took damage from the jumping.
I'm super sad I didn't get to kill anyone else, though. I mean, I had such good stuff for so long.
Oh, yeah.
Diamond sword from the beginning of episode 2. I had a diamond sword, a bow, like 20 arrows, and a diamond pickaxe, and full iron armor, and like 2 gold apples to spare. I was looking for people all the time, and all I got was a cheap kill in the beginning of a video that I mostly feel ashamed for.
Yeah. Who got the most kills this season?
Had to be Etho, right? You got like
4.
Right?
I think I got 4.
Damn guy.
I died to mobs. How did you get potions?
From your chest where you guys died.
Shut up.
And from B-double-O.
Oh, you left.
stuff in a chest?
I left. I was like, I was looking through it and I was panicked and I was like, I don't, I'm sitting by a village. People are going to come ambush me. I got to get out of here. And I was like, I got everything.
You
I
know had a strength three potion?
Yeah, I got that. I got that.
I was like, actually, I was trying to piece it together what happened.
You see a beer, though. I mean, like.
So you actually topped the sharpness 5 sword now?
Oh, yeah, this is much worse.
Awesome.
I got it. There, and it's like, I see the two player heads. I see the two player heads, and I'm like, okay, so what happened here exactly? There's stuff in the chest. Nebris and Pyro are just sitting there with, like, their heads are there. There's still stuff in the chest. Like, there's still potion stuff. There's an instant health.
And you left that?
That's what I'm saying!
And then I clued in. It's like, you know, I saw B00 go up in health really quick all of a sudden. I bet you he came, he placed their heads, and is just
and left
laughing his head off that he has potions now. He took the brewing stand, though.
Yeah, damn right I took it.
I told you something about the brouhaha, and I was like, how does he know he's got a brewing station? Did he see him brewing?
Fricker, as soon as you said that, I was like, crap, I left a potion over there. I know I did.
You're going to get so much for that, now. Though, man.
Oh, people aren't even going to let me play it anymore.
You're bad at PvP.
Oh, man.